Hello my friends, welcome on this video tutorial. Daniel is here from Tips to Fix. Today I will show you how to check mails from other accounts using your Gmail control panel, your Gmail email account. I will show you how to add your business email address. And maybe you don't like checking the emails from the default Webmail account from your hosting provider. I'm not talking about using G Suite. G Suite is very professional. If you want more space, if you want extra things, you have to use G Suite. But in this case, I'm talking about checking emails from other accounts for free. The reason you can use this platform is it's more easy to use because maybe you are more familiar to Gmail. And the other thing is using this method, you can release some space from your web hosting server. All the emails can go on the Gmail and automatically will delete it from your web hosting server. That's amazing features. So let me show you right now. Okay, let's continue now and let's go directly to the point. Okay, we are here on the Gmail. So we are here on Gmail right now. And what we have to do first, we have to go here on the settings. You see, settings, we will see here all settings. And here on Gmail settings, you have here a tab, it's account and import. Here on this area, check email from other accounts. You have to click here, add an email account. Okay, click here, put your business email address here. In my case, I will check here in my hosting provider and I will see the email address I want to configure. I want to configure this sales and sednacast.com. I'm here on my hosting control panel, is cPanel control panel. And go to manage here. Manage, I will generate a password. Yes. And connected device, and I will see all the settings we need to use for configuring this email address to my Gmail account. Okay, let's see. Email address is sales. Okay, click next. Click next. Username. You see, username here is sales at sednacast.com. Password is the one we generated. Paste it here. Pop server, you see, is mail at mail.sednacast.com. Here you have some options. If you want to let a copy of your email in your server, you can uncheck this option here. Leave a copy of retrieving message on the server. If you don't want a copy of your email on your server, if you don't have that much space on your hosting provider, on your hosting server, and you don't want emails to stay on your server, on your own server, uncheck this. You have to uncheck this option. And then all the emails will come on the server, stay for 20 seconds and will disappear. They deleted it automatically, okay? But if you want a copy of your emails also to be on your server, then check this option. But for the moment, I don't want any copy on my server because I don't have that much space. So I don't have to leave a copy on my own server, okay? Always use a secure connection. Yes, I want to label incoming messages. Label is here. It will list it here on the left panel. And you will see sales and sednacast.com. And you will see it here. You can check emails directly from here. Archive incoming messages. Skip the inbox. I don't suggest you using this option. So leave it as it is. Leave it empty. Leave it like this. Okay? I will use port 995. Put the port 995. And yes, now your mail account has been added. Yes, I want to be able to send mail and as a sales on sednacast.com. Okay, yeah, click next. name it. Put the name. This name, it will appear on your title when you send emails. Click next step. Here it's asking you for SMTP server because you want to be able to send emails now from this email address. You can check the which email address you will use when you send emails to others. Okay, configure this main username. Put the same username you have, the same password as we did before, and use secure connection using TLS recommended from Google. If you use SSL, it will be this port 465, but if you want to use TLS, let it as it is. By default, Google chooses 586 and click add account. And now you see it will work. You will see with email a code, verification code coming from Google. Check the email here on the server and you will see the email will disappear after 30 seconds. The list is empty and let's see. Just do a refresh here. Let's wait for an email from Google. Okay, here it is. We have email from Google. Copy this code. We need this code. And you will see this email, it will disappear after 30 seconds. And paste it here, because we have to verify our account. Here it is. The email address is here. And you will see, here we are. I did a refresh here on Gmail, and you will see here a label with sales and Sednacast. Click on this, click refresh. Let's see where the email is. Okay, you see the email is deleted from my server directly, and it came here on the Gmail. Okay, here it is. The first email we receive on this email address, it comes here on Gmail. So let's do a test now. Let's send an email. So we will send an email from tips2fix@gmail.com to sales@sednacast.com and we will see what will happen. Click send. You will see an email here now. Okay, here I have an email, just me sending an email. It's me here, you can see. Yeah, but the email is here on this inbox. You will see email here on the hosting server. It will appear for some seconds and will be deleted directly. Test three, and send. You see? Okay, I just send a test 4 from another email address, and let's see here, refresh here. Okay, test 3 is deleted automatically from the server. We will see test 4. Okay, here is test 4. It's sent from me. It's personal. Let's see if we receive it here on Gmail. Here it is. Test 4 is received here. You will see. Okay. This is sent from my personal account and you see here on the server it will be deleted automatically now. Okay, look at this, we lost from here and we have the email directly here. And here in the inbox it will notify you this email, it came to sales@sednacast.com. So if you have any other question guys, just write me a comment here on the comment area. I really suggest you using this method. You can add more than one email address. If you have any other questions, just write me a comment on your comment area and let me know if you have any difficulties. Don't forget to subscribe Tips to Fix and share this video with your friends. Let's help them all. God bless you and see you on the next video tutorial.